Assalamu alaikum. This is your brother, Majid Mahmoud, recording for the Daily Reminder. Brothers and sisters, how many people were on the straight path but eventually deviated away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? I hope you're not that person, and I hope you're not a person when you see a sinner sinning, you make fun of them and you mock them while you think you're so holy and you'll always live upon La ilaha illallah and you will die upon La ilaha illallah. Brothers and sisters, there was a man who was known to be practicing, at least externally speaking, performed Umrah, used to pray, and used to be his Islamic teacher's right hand in everything that he does. After several years, and I'm telling you this story because I witnessed it personally, I heard it with my own ears, seen it with my own eyes, that brother kept leaving Islam and the teachings of Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to an extent that one time he was passing by a poster, by a picture that had Allah's name on it. As he was passing by, he looked at it and he said, "Who put my name there? A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem." We seek Allah's refuge from such attitude. Brothers and sisters, there's so many lessons that can be taken from this story. Na'am, such a short story, so many lessons. But I want to take one of them out of this, which is, you never know where will you die, and how will you die, and at what state will your heart be at. Brothers and sisters, we shall not take Allah's guidance to us for granted. Can you believe that when Umm Salama, the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the mother of the believers, my mother and your mother, if you were a believer who was watching, and if you're not, may Allah guide you, Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Can you believe when she was asked, what was the most common dua the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has ever said? What was the most common dua that you've ever heard the Prophet saying? You know what was her response? And before I move forward, what an amazing question that is, isn't it? She said, yes, the most common dua I've ever heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam make. Are you ready to memorize? Are you ready to apply? Are you ready to take action? Yes, inshaAllah. The most common dua the Prophet ever made was, Ya muqallib al-qulub, O flipper of the hearts, O rotator of the hearts, ثبت قلبي على دينك, hold my heart steadfast upon your deen. Allahu Akbar, if this was a dua of a man who was promised the highest level in Jannah, the man who was promised that Allah will forgive and overlook any shortcoming or any sin that he has done in the past, had he ever done any. And any sin or any shortcoming that he ever do in the future is already forgiven. ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. Allahu Akbar. With all of this, he still made that dua, asking Allah, O flipper of the hearts, hold my heart steadfast upon your deen. So brothers and sisters, what about me and you? What about poor people like me and you who sin day and night? We ask Allah to allow us to be steadfast. And the only time me and you are to be confident we are going to Jannah, inshaAllah, you know when? When the angel of death descends, comes right by your head, as in Sahih Muslim, and comes to you and is about to extract your soul from your body, and the angel of death says the following to you.
يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية فادخلي في عبادي وادخلي جنتي.
يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية فادخلي في عبادي وادخلي جنتي. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow you to hear these words from the angel of death. And may Allah make you steadfast and die upon La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Feel free to like the video. Make sure you share it with your friends and family. May Allah make you as means for the whole ummah to be steadfast. Barakallahu feekum. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.